Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video tutorial, I'll explain how to customize the SyncFusionReact carousel component. I'll show you how to customize the navigators and indicators, change the slide interval time, disable slides autoplay, and infinite slide transition looping, and change animation. I open my existing example, where I have already installed the SyncFusionReact navigations package, and written the basic rendering code for SyncFusion carousel component. I have added the slides, using template property in carousel item directive tag. You can watch my carousel getting started video to learn the basics of rendering the component and adding slides, the link for which I've shared in the card above and description below. Let me run this application and show you the carousel. See here, carousel is rendered and slides are added to it. First, we will see how to customize the navigators and the carousel component. I'm going to use the SyncFusion button component for navigators. So, I install the SyncFusion EJ2 React Buttons package and import the button component. To customize the previous button, I use the previous button template property and assign the method CustomPreviousButton. Inside this method, I add the button component tag with the class name eButton, CSS class eFlatAround, and icon CSS property eIcon C chevron left double. I then include the next button template property and assign the method custom next button. In that method, I include the button component and assign the class eIcon C chevron right double to the icon CSS property. Checking now, the previous and next buttons are customized. Let me show you how to customize the indicators. Here I'm going to show the preview of each slide. First, I declare the array variable birds and assign the list of array values. Then, I include the indicator template property and assign the method CustomIndicator. Inside that method, I include the wrapper element with the class name indicator and add the image tag with source, accessing from the SyncFusion demo. Using this array variable, I'll get the image name. I open the app.css page and include the CSS style for indicators. I change the wrapper height to 350 pixels. Checking now, you can preview each slide in the indicator. By default, the transition is enabled and the interval between two slides is 5 seconds. To change the slide transition time, I include the interval property and set its value to 2 seconds. You can also set a different interval for individual carousel items using the interval property. Checking now, the slide interval time is reduced. Carousel has two built-in animations for slide transition, slide and fade. The default is slide. To change that, include the animation property and set its effect to fade. Looking at it now, the animation effect has changed. By setting the effect as none, you can disable the animation during slide transition. See, animation is disabled. Next, I will show you how to enable the play button. I include the show play button property and set its value to true. See here, the play button is shown. Using it, I can control the autoplay action. Notice that when the last slide is reached, the transition moves the carousel back to first slide. You can disable this infinite looping by adding a loop property and setting its value to false. Now, when the last slide is reached, the slideshow stops. I click the play button to start the carousel again. Next, I'll show you how to disable the auto slide transition. I include the autoplay property and set its value to false. Check now, the slide transition is disabled. I can navigate the slides using the previous and next buttons. Finally, I will show you how to customize the play button in carousel. Here I'm going to show the caption play or pause instead of an icon using the SyncFusion button. To explain this example, I enable the loop and autoplay properties. I add the play button template property. Then I define the custom play button method. Inside that method, I define the template by adding button component with class name eButton. Then set the content as pause. I also add the onClick event and assign the callback method buttonClick. Then I declare a variable buttonObject and use it in the ref property of the button component to access its instance. In the same way, I declare another variable carouselObject and use it in the ref property of the carousel component. In the buttonClick method, check whether autoplay is enabled in carousel, I disable it, and change button content to play, and vice versa. Assign this method to the play button template property. Check now, play or pause button is rendered with text instead of icons. I can pause the slideshow or play it using that button. In this video, I have shown you how to customize the SyncFusion React Carousel components, navigator buttons, and indicators. I also showed you how to customize the animation and slide transitions. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our React products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.